This is the story of a wealthy family who drifted apart and the one podcast who could bring them all together again. It's Roleplay Retcon does Arrested Development, Fateful Consequences.
I accomplished my goal. Do I get 2 points?
Yeah, go ahead and give yourself 2 points.
Okay, cool.
What was your goal?
Thank you.
What was your goal again?
To get back with maybe.
So Michael is going back to the apartment. Actually, you know, it's going to be during the Cinco de Cuatro celebration in the evening, during the party. He's going to go up to his mother, Lucille, and he's going to ask to be released from the company. To be fired, because for some reason he can't quit. It's in like a clause or something. Mother, I was trying to get... The main reason I came back was for some weird loophole. I'm still an employee of the Bluth Company, and I would like to be released from the light treasons that have plagued this family and move on with my life with my own company.
Moving on to Arizona, you mean?
Phoenix, Arizona. Yes, Mother. It's a major city.
Well, you know, I'd rather be alive in California than dead in Arizona. But if, you know, if what are we going to do with your shares, though? Who's going to get your shares if I let you out of the contract?
You know what? I'm going to be the president of my own company. You can keep my shares. Give it to some North Korean or an Australian for all I care.
I do have a situation in North Korea I need to deal with. So in that case, I think I can have the paperwork drawn up. But we can't tell your father about this.
I mean,
you know how he gets.
There's no reason for him to know.
I wanted to contest the scene.
Hey, it's Ben. Just like the last episode, I am going to just summarize what happens in these bidding wars. This time, Charlie wins. He contests and no one beats him, so he wins. And he gets to control the sentence.
So as soon as Lucille says that was Lucille, right, you were talking
yes.
to? Okay, she says she has some business in North Korea. We get a flash to her and George are loading boxes of hot ham water onto a cargo pallet that is stamped with a symbol of North Korea.
Ew. Wow.
Good callback, though. It has a smack of ham.
Is that all you're adding?
Yeah.
Okay. All those tokens for that.
So I guess you get a token for a callback.
Yeah, for sure.
But also, me and Lucille were doing some shenanigans together, so I'd say that we're back at it. Like,
well, you said that was a flashback, so I don't think that counts.
Well, it was a flashback to, like, you know.
Yeah, it counts.
It was a flashback to the future, sure.
Within the time period of this
flashback to the future.
So
context of this.
You didn't alter the thing, so I still get my 2 points. For yeah. that, you spent your 10, so get those out of there.
I'm going to eat them because they're gummy bears.
I'm going to give myself a point for being family oriented, for going to my mother and asking her to release me. And then I used 3 secret words.
Oh, jeez. Snap.
All right, let's do it. Let's hear it.
So I said I wanted to get away from the family and its many light treasons that it's committed with this company. My mother could give my shares, to any person she found, like a North Korean or an Australian, whoever. And I have no idea, I'm gonna say something for Tobias.
Okay. Because I've just really been giving mine away.
I think I have no idea, but I think Tobias is still a never nude, but it's evolved past just the jean shorts, the jorts, and now involves vests with the fringe.
Okay. You didn't actually say exactly the words. Mm-hmm. I think you have it, though. I think you guessed it.
Did I get all five of the words, or just about?
My secret is my never nude condition is worse.
Yeah.
I now always wear a denim vest, too.
Yeah!
Nice!
Got him!
That's amazing.
Oh, that's great.
So my five words were never nude condition, worse denim vest, and you didn't quite say that, but it was pretty close.
Nice!
Cool. I mean, I'll count it.
So technically I'm supposed to be out, but I only get one more turn anyway, so...
Yeah.
In my turn, I will make myself leave.
That's cool. So okay. I got 9 for my secret words, and then I got... I'll just say 3 more for getting one of your other secret words.
So what does that what does that mean with like me, where my goal is kind of resting on Tobias?
Well, now you said you did your goal basically.
I kind of did. He did agree to be in one of my films.
Yeah, I mean basically you can come up with another goal now. Like I've got to come up with another goal.
Okay.
Technically you're supposed to, but I didn't, because I knew this was coming.
All right, so my turn is done. Now, Franz.
Howdy. Okay, so what we're going to do here is that we're going to be... So they're neighbors, right? Lucille, too, and then, like, everyone else, they're neighbors. Forgetting names left and right here. So what he's going to do is he's killed the seal. It's done. It's over. He's won the court case against PETA, and now... What he's going to do is he is going to ask Lucille 2 out again for real this time, maybe. And what he does, he brings his mom with him for moral support. And and he's there, and he knocks on the door, but he knocks on the door, and he immediately starts freaking out. And he hides behind his mom. And he talks to Lucille 2 through, like, from behind his mom's back and asks her out.
Ben, you're out now. You can play Lucille 2.
Ooh, Ben, you want to do this with me, Ben? You want to do Lucille too?
I can. If Alex wills it, I will.
Alex is not in charge.
What? Tell me what to do, though. What am I supposed to do exactly? Oh, Buster! Buster, you came. How very grand. Who plays her? She's like Hollywood royalty.
Oh my god, it's Liza Minnelli.
Liza Minnelli.
Yeah.
Broadway.
So this is my best Liza Minnelli.
She's amazing.
You did good. You did good.
I killed a seal.
Oh dear. You killed your mother for me?
No. Lucille is standing right in front of you.
Oh. I didn't see you there, darling. You know how we are with our jokes.
The loose seal of the I exacted my revenge.
That's so shocking, Buster. Buster, I feel like...
Yes.
Buster, I'm overcome with this gesture you've done for me.
Yes.
I feel as though I'm falling.
For me?
Help me, catch me, I'm falling, catch me.
Does she actually...
Lucille Estero loses her balance and begins to fall.
Okay, well, we can do this two ways. We can do this three ways. Oh god, what if he stabs her?
We can do
her?
It all the ways.
Well, okay, hold on there. What if he accidentally stabbed her? That'd be hilarious.
Well, would it or would it be really upsetting and bad?
Foreshadowing.
Anyway, what do you want? So, she does. She accepts him back into their life. They kiss and stuff.
Yes.
And do grown-up times, probably.
Well, yeah. I did a thing. He brought his mom with him, and he also panicked. What else is there? He's loyal? I don't know.
Well, that one? Real quick, does anyone want to contest this happy ending with Buster?
No.
No.
No. This is interesting.
All right.
This is very educational.
You definitely get one point for being panicky and bustery. You get 2 points for finishing your shabam, your goal.
Is it 1 point per descriptive, or is it just like one if you get any of them?
It's just one if you get any of them. Did you say any secret words?
No.
Do you want to guess anyone's secret? Secret.
No.
You got a secret. I got a secret. I got it. I got that joke.
You got that joke. I got the joke. All right. Well, that's done for you. We'll move on to Caleb. Job.
After overhearing his father's and Michael's conversation in the courtroom, warning him about the cornballer filings, Job sees an opportunity to win his father's praises and goes back to the apartment to collect the filings that he had previously asked them to collect from Buster's hook. On his way out, after collecting the filings, on his way out, he bumps into George Michael.
Hey, that's me.
It is you. Ba-bump.
Hey, what's going on?
Oh, hey, George Michael. How's the banana stand?
You know it burned down.
Regardless. Hey, you still have impeccable timing, right?
Yes, I do.
How would you like to join an organization? Wait, can you drive? How old are you?
Yes, I can. I am a full-grown adult.
Excellent. Come with me. Job puts his arm around George Michael. Have you seen the movie Now You See Me? I have both of them on Blu-ray 1 and 2 back in my apartment. Come on, they're Steve's favorite movies.
Yeah, I've seen those.
Job pauses and realizes the thing he had been chasing was a father-son relationship with George Sr. this whole time. But he had spent the last 10 years teetering on the precipice of that relationship with his own son, Steve Holt. He hands the filings to George Michael. Your father needs these. Tell him I said you're welcome.
Okay. What is this?
These are the secret filings that he needs. Tell him I gave them to you specifically.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay.
Good boy. And, okay. And Job leaves.
Okay.
Okay.
That's the end of mine.
Is that the end of yours? Okay.
I told you, I am grabbing those curtains and sprinting on Job.
I got you. Okay, so, did you act out any of your traits?
I believe vain and condescending. Oh, I didn't really play it out. I was going for a condescending thing about how's the banana stand.
I'll give it to you. That's one point. Did you do your goal?
No, I know it's not in the rules, but I'm kind of electing to forgo my goal, because
That's fine.
He realized the different goals, so I don't think I should get points for it, but, I think I wrapped that up.
You actually, we may have said this or we may have not, I may have accidentally forgot to say this, you actually get points if your sentence reinforces your relationship with another character. I do think I forgot to say that, so we'll give you points for that. How about that? You get two if you reinforce relationship.
All right. Did you say any secret words?
I did. I said two secret words.
Let's hear them sentences.
Come, Job says and wraps his arm around George Michael. Have you seen the movie Now You See Me? I have both of them on Blu-ray, 1 and 2. And then also... Hey, you still have impeccable timing, right? How would you like to join an organization? Wait, can you drive? How old are you?
All right. Would you like to guess anyone else's secret?
Let's see. No, not really. Am I allowed to let other people try to guess mine?
They will on their turns.
Okay.
All right, Kim.
You really want people to know it, huh?
I'm trying to lay it out pretty plain and simple.
I got nothing, man.
Yeah, I think I made it too hard to guess, honestly.
I may have too, honestly. Kim, let's hear what Lindsay's up to.
Let's see. So he succeeded in his goal. Okay. So Lindsay and Tobias are discussing the terms of their divorce then. Basically for the rest of her life to be funded by alimony. Because if he's going to make this step to leave her, then she just needs to be taken care of for the rest of her life, because he has obviously made it big and he has everything he wants. So why shouldn't she have everything she wants?
All right. Does anyone want to contest this?
Yeah.
Kim doesn't have any tokens because she bid them all earlier. So Jeanette ends up only having to put down one token to take control of the sentence.
All right, Jeanette, how do you want to rewrite that?
Just change everything from Lindsay to maybe.
Yeah, all right.
Okay. basically, I don't want Lindsay. Like, I love my mom, but, like, I'm trying to use my dad. So, I want that money to go to, or the money and the fame and whatever to go to maybe, so.
Yeah, so let's say this.
So, Lindsay tries at this, probably a lawyer hearing to use all of her whims and charm to get Tobias to dote on her with his money. But, through some incoherent mumbling from his lawyer and just him being not oblivious, or being completely oblivious to everything, somehow gets it all written off to maybe.
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Yeah, I was thinking, like, it had already happened. Like,
oh yeah, like it was too late. It was too late. Maybe had already gotten it.
He got this part in this movie, and he just throws away all the good stuff in his life because he was like, the universe gave me a sign, but Lindsay, a sign.
Hold on. It did really already happen, though, because when I took control of her conversation, I was like, yes, all of that happens, and also we get together. Yeah, so I didn't negate any of the stuff that she had said.
Yep. Yeah, I technically got my goal.
So he just completely throws away his entire life to go be in a Bollywood movie.
A Bollywood movie. A big yellow joint, a big yellow joint. I'll meet
you down at the big yellow joint. Hey everyone, hey!
Welcome to the break. I hope you're enjoying the finale, or what should be the finale, of Arrested Development, Fateful Consequences.
I'm like 99% sure it is.
Oh yeah.
Unless I find some like secret fourth episode under in my yard or something.
There's always extra episodes of the Banana Shack.
Thank you to all six of our guests. They were great.
So many of them.
I don't know. We've never named them in the break. Thank you to Franz. Thank you to Kim and Anna and Caleb and Kim and Charlie. I did get them all.
You said Kim twice, and did you get Caleb? You got Caleb, and the other one is Jeanette, my wife.
I call Jeanette Kim, so that's why I got about that.
Wow. Wow.
So, we need to talk about Realms of Peril and Glory.
Realms if you listened of to the break Peril last time, and Glory.
You heard me talk about this last time, but I wanted to talk about it again because now I've actually had a chance to listen to it. But just to tell you what it is, real quick, Realms of Peril and Glory is it's an actual play podcast, kind of like ours. And each season of it is going to be a new story. This season is called Veil, and it's an epic mystery thriller set in New Harbor, which is a city of magic, monsters, and machines. Yeah, they started out with three episodes last when they started, which was, I don't remember the date now, but I think there's five now. There's four, maybe five. I'm not quite caught up yet.
Let's not date the episode. There's episodes. Let's not date listen to them.
There's episodes, but there's a lot. You have a lot to catch up on regardless.
And they put a new one out every Wednesday, right?
Yep, every week.
So, yeah.
They have lots of guest players. There's someone from the Magnus Archive, Sasha Sienna. Ooh. Oh yeah, no, Magnus Archives. That's one of the big ones. But also Alba Salix's Sean Howard and Wooden Overcoat's Beth Eyer and Felix Trench.
These are some like really cool names.
I know, right? Everyone has cooler names than we do.
Ugh.
Right. I need a cool name.
I mean, you guys have cool names. Don't feel bad.
Thank you.
I've had a chance to listen to a couple of episodes now. So, like, the first episode is, like, you getting to know the characters, and it's very good. It's got a lot of, like, original music and a lot of good sound design to it. And then the second episode is like basically a big fight. Their first big fight in the system they're using, which is not Dungeons and Dragons, but like, damn, I can't remember what it's called. I'll remember next time, okay? I'll write it down. I'll remember next time. But it's a cool system. And they get in this big fight, and they do character work during the fight.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, in a way that I'm like, why have I never thought of doing this? Like, and it's so good. They somehow evade the like RPG actual play podcast combat like doldrums, and it's really great. You can find them anywhere you find podcasts, or you can go to our Roleplay Retcon's specific unique link to get there, which is www.lightandtragic.com/retcon.
Yeah.
I'll put that in the show notes too, just in case you didn't catch that. But check them out, and I'm going to roll a trailer for you right now.
Welcome to Realms of Peril and Glory, an all-new actual play podcast.
There are guided tours once a week. Come on, Dark Brennan.
How about you, you filthy timepiece?
RPG is home to hilarious stories.
The thing that kicks off a really good tale is...
when they take their tops off.
Sorry?
When you're reading, like... Don't worry.
And thrilling adventures.
There's bad guys, there's an ogre. Probably best if you stay here. Sorry, I'll be back soon.
Why am I tied up?
That was your sibling, not me. Bye.
Each season is an all-new actual play story told collaboratively at the table, featuring guest players from the Magnus Archives.
I remember being in the water, and that was awful. And now I'm not in the water, and that's... much better.
Wooden overcoats.
I am a snowman. I have one job, and that is to stand in place. I was doing that very well.
Yes, and she might come back 9 times more powerful with lots of food and kippers.
We fix space junk.
On the surface, you might look different, but you're very, very similar inside. And I can vouch for that.
And more.
What I am about to tell you stays in this room. Got it?
Don't happen know where there's like secret plans about meat and smoothies.
Ducks? Did you say ducks? Did you say ducks? Did you say duck?
You can find Realms of Peril and Glory wherever you listen to podcasts.
We're gonna have a good laugh, then we're gonna possibly cry, and then we'll grab dinner.
Please do check out Realms of Peril and Glory. They're awesome, and we like them. But you know who else is awesome? Nerdsmith. And we are part of Nerdsmith, and we love them, and they have tons of podcasts and streams, so please check out Nerdsmith.
We are Nerdsmith.
The next episode is on September 15th, and that is the rehash episode, Roleplay Rehash. We do this at the end of every series.
So get in your submissions now on how you would fix the last... one or two seasons of Arrested Development, or just let us know what you thought of how we did.
Or talk to us about what you thought of soap, or like really anything. And we'll read it and talk about it on the episode.
Literally anything.
I don't know if I want to put out literally anything. I don't
just let me know how your parents are doing, because I haven't heard from them in a while.
Did you do something to your parents?
I didn't do anything to my parents.
No, we're asking them.
Oh.
What?
Oh.
Did you do something? Sean?
Sean?
What happened to your parents?
Where are your parents, Sean? Without further ado, let's get back to the episode. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, kisses.
A big yellow joint. A big yellow joint. I'll meet you down at the big yellow joint.
All right. We'll move on to Charlie, George Bluth.
Okay, so the scene opens with George Michael in the kitchen of Lucille's apartment, her condo, with Lucille there. And then he is packing things into a box marked hot ham water. Lucille is working on something on the counter, as well as Lucy Ill, also packing things into a hot ham water box. And George Michael walks into the room.
Hello.
Hey, George, George Michael, could you give us a hand here?
Yes.
You see that cornball there? The one with the there's no numbers on the timer there. You see that?
Yes.
Grab that and start putting them in the boxes.
Okay, I do that thing.
And you get burned immediately.
Oh my god, it burned me.
It's still plugged in.
It's still plugged in.
Oh yeah, those things are hot.
Why would you do this to me? Why wouldn't you?
I'm sorry. Unplug it and put it in the box.
Okay.
Wait, we don't have much time left. Lucille, what how much time do we have left? Lucille knows that they are planning on catching a flight soon, and they have to get their inventory together as soon as possible.
We've got about 2 hours. North Korea is the only country with nutrition requirements that would take the cornballers. We've got to get them there in 2 hours. The flight leaves.
Hush about the cornballers. It's a hot ham water. You know this.
I don't know what any of these words mean.
George Michael, just keep putting them in the boxes.
Okay, I'm putting them in the boxes.
Good job. Good work, son.
Thank
you. I'm telling you, that head of hair is something else. You know,
thank you.
A couple years ago,
I like my hair, too. It's very curly and fluffy.
Oh, come on. I got
and
yours.
Get away from this family? Absolutely.
All right, Charlie.
We've got to go. Lucille, you're ready to start our new life over in North Korea? I love you, baby. And that's the end of the scene.
Does anyone want to contest this scene?
Charlie only has one token to defend, and a lot of people bid during this round. Anna, who plays Lucille Bluth, wins with 7.
So Anna, how do you want to resolve this scene? What do you want to change?
So I'm going to essentially leave it pretty much as is. They're packing up the hot ham water and they're about to skip town. Lucille realizes that she doesn't actually remember how to read a clock because Lupe has been telling her what time it is for the last 20 years.
Oh, nice.
So Lucille realizes that they have 6 hours before they have to be at the airport to catch their secret flight to North Korea. So they realize they have a little bit of time to play with.
Okay. So they have more time to play with.
Is it actually hot ham water? Is it like really just like water from hams?
Yeah, like what is this?
Okay, so there's a joke in season 3 where Lindsay learns how to cook, kind of, where she just makes water with ham in it. And you drink the water.
Like boiled ham? Ew.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Gross.
Disgusting.
She does a grosser thing with like chicken sauce where it's
cool. We're not gonna talk about that. Or we're gonna continue on.
Well, Charlie, did you I'm pretty sure you probably did your traits. So you get a point for that. Did you do any secret words?
I did. I did 4 out of 5.
You did 4?
Yeah, he did.
Oh wow. Okay.
Hey, for the interest of time, can we just have Caleb guess it? Since we're at the end here anyway.
Have him say the sentences that they were in though.
Yeah, do the sentences real quick.
Okay, grab that cornballer over there, the one with the timer with the numbers worn off on it. You know we're selling these boxes to the North Koreans and they're not gonna wait on us. Yeah, that's it, right? Yeah, that's it.
All right. So you get 12 tokens for that. Caleb, go ahead and try to guess what it is.
Okay, I know a part of it is you're definitely not George Sr. and I assume you're trying to escape to North Korea to like in the show, they go to Mexico and the cornballer is still huge over there. And so I assume he's trying to recreate that in North Korea under the guise of George Sr. Is that at all close?
Under the guise of George Sr.? That is close.
What words did he get? Did he get close?
Cornballers selling North Korea.
All right, so we got 3.
And the Oscar thing wasn't really like I was planning on revealing that at some point, but we didn't have time to, so that was kind of the intention all along.
All right. Mm. So we'll move on to... Oh, and I guess you got your goal. You're running away with Lucille, so get two more tokens. Lucille, Anna, get it.
All right, so Lucille's goal has already been accomplished with Buster and Lucille Ostero going off. So a little bit of a flashback. She comes back into the apartment and tells George Sr., hey, they've run off together, so we're good to go. Realizing now that they have 6 hours to burn before they have to go to North Korea, Lucille basically entices George Sr. to go on a date, because why not? They're feeling all excited after the hot ham water situation, and decide to go try to recreate the magic of that conjugal trailer without Warden Gentle being a time cop. Very romantic.
You know, there's a construction site down the street.
So they get into their Ford Escape and drive down to town, and Lucille decides to go to a jazz club. They think they're like going to a really cool hip club, but they actually end up going to like a dusty old claptrap that's got wooden panels, and it's kind of a very old school club. As they walk in, someone very vaguely recognizes Lucille, and she gets kind of pleased, but also like a little bit bashful, which is kind of odd for Lucille. George comments on it and wants to know what that was about, because he thinks he heard them call her name under their breath when she passed by, but he couldn't really make out the name. So that's the scene.
Who's your friend?
Oh, who knows? You know, they everyone here goes by stage names. They probably just thought I might have been someone else.
Stage names. What did he call you?
Oh, you know, it's not important. You know how these jazzy speakeasies are. And with that, she gets really bashful, but immediately goes up to the front row and starts making eyes at the piano guy. And then George gets a little jealous, and Lucille's really eating it up. They stay for, you know, a song or two, and then they decide to go break into that construction trailer down the street. And that's the scene.
All right. Anybody want to contest any of that?
No, it's beautiful, amazing, I love it.
Yeah, how romantic.
Okay, Anna, did you do any of your traits?
Maybe, I don't know.
I think you were more limited.
I don't think it was necessarily meaner. Yeah, it was manipulative getting George Sr. to go to the jazz club. I don't think it was.
Get you.
I think callback for the Ford Escape, though.
Definitely, there's so many callbacks in that. Dusty clam trap.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The conjugal, conjugal trailer.
Yep.
It's all very good.
Conjugal trailer.
You got any secret words in there for us?
I do have some secret words.
Let's hear them sentences.
So since it was all sort of narrative, I'll sort of recap, I guess, the mm-hmm. narration. But they went to what they thought was going to be a pretty hip place, but it ended up being just kind of a musty old jazz club. Lucille got mistaken, but she shrugged off the concern that George Sr. had by saying, oh, you know how it goes in these places. They always go by stage names. And that's it.
Okay. I guess we'll extend. Does anyone want to guess Anna's secret?
I want to guess it.
Well, that's not how she would guess someone else's secret.
Well, I'm gonna do that too.
Okay.
We're just speeding things up. Jency, what would you want to guess is Anna's secret?
All right,
Lucille's.
My guess is that Lucille has secretly been playing piano at a jazz club under a stage name.
Very good. Pretty close. Close enough that, I don't know, I think we might have to give it to her.
Hip is in there somewhere.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, at a hip jazz club.
Is it Musty Hip? Is that the stage name?
Yeah!
Oh, jeez.
Ew.
Is Oscar the piano player?
Oh my god, this is so much better than I even could have thought. That would have been brilliant. Oh my god, why didn't I think of that? No, so Lucille's secret is that after offering the Bluth Company shares to sell to Stan Sitwell, she realized that money was going to run out really quick. So she's been moonlighting as a lounge singer performing jazz standards around Newport Beach's oldest and mustiest jazz clubs under a secret stage name for tip money to make ends meet. The big secret is that she actually likes the attention.
Nice. I also had the word standard. I didn't say that out loud, but very cool. Nice.
Cool. Let's backtrack just a second. Charlie, was there anybody you wanted to guess the secret of?
Oh.
Do I get points for that?
Oh, yeah. Job. Job wants to be a... he wants to get in on the production of Now You See Me 3. Somehow he wants to start his acting career, and now you see.
No, not quite.
No,
you're getting there. You just need to be a little more Joe ridiculous.
Did he say any new secret words?
You got Now You See Me. What was your whole guess again?
That you wanted to get in on the production of.
Okay, one of the words was join. So Now You See Me and join.
Join, yeah.
I was going to guess Job as well, that he's sort of accidentally perpetuated a cult. So instead of the Alliance of Magicians, it's become a cult that is somehow kleptomaniacs that are watching Now You See Me 1 and 2 on Blu-ray.
That's getting closer, but that's still not quite it.
Yeah.
All right.
Do I get 2 points for guessing?
You get 2 points.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
All right. All right, Jensi, go for it. Last scene.
Oh my gosh, it's my turn. Okay, so I have already reached kind of my goal about trying to get back with maybe. But now I have a new goal. Do I have to say my new goal?
Sure. Yeah, go for it.
Okay. So, my new goal is to enter a relationship with maybe by being completely transparent with her.
All right. Let's knock out your scene.
Okay, cool. So, our first round of coffee went great. She got her dad's money or whatever, and she decided that it was like a full date, and she'll also liked me. So now we are having our second date, and we just saw a movie, and it was cute and it was romantic, and we held hands, and then afterward we had dinner, and hey, maybe. So like, I just wanted to clear up some things from the past, you know, like I know we talked about that lead singer, Jeff, and how you were totally into him and how much, like, you think, like, his music is great and it's like a bop and it's fire or whatever, but, like, you don't still like him or anything, do you?
I mean, there might be a little bit, but, I mean, I could be swayed.
But, like, not as much as me, right? Because we have, like, a better history and, like, I'm cooler and you like me more.
Well, we're so close. We're so close that, like, we're almost related, you know? Almost.
Yeah,
almost
so, like, related. Almost, but, like, we're not. And you know how, like, people who are married are related and they have the same last name, right? Okay. Well, I'm getting there. I'm sorry. So I want maybe to marry me. So I get down on one knee and I say, okay, maybe. So I would like for you to take my last name and then we can be fully officially related by marriage. Will you marry me?
No. You gotta say, marry me.
All right. Does anyone want to contest
yes.
this? All right, Jensi, how much points you do?
This one's just too exciting to cut. I'm actually going to let this bidding war play out like it did. You get to hear the whole thing.
One.
Jeanette, how much points you do?
3.
Ben.
Pass.
Alright, I'm gonna do like...
God damn it.
10. I'm gonna do 10 points.
What?
Wow. Franz. No.
9.
Caleb?
I'll do 12.
What?
12 for Caleb.
Why?
Kim.
0.
Charlie.
13.
Oh, what?
Can I have any
stake in this?
Pass.
I feel
I'm
like
I'm loving the chaos. I'm passing.
Yeah.
Gypsy, do you have more than 13?
No, you know I don't.
Jeanette, do you have more than 13?
No.
All right. I'm going to put up 14.
Oh, jeez.
I hate you guys so much.
Who is next?
I'm going to put up 15.
What?
Caleb, 15. Charlie.
Dang. No, I only have 15.
I'm gonna let Caleb have that.
All right. What you changing?
Okay. I'm pretty much going to leave it the same. Although he George Michael says, maybe marry me, maybe.
Perfect.
Wow. That was so good, Caleb.
Thank you.
That was an excellent. worth every point.
I had 16 and I just wanted to use them before the game was over.
That was beautiful.
All right.
So, Jensi, you got your trait. You were dorky as hell. You got your second goal, 2 more points. Did you have any secret words?
Yes.
How many of them secret words did you have?
Hold on, let me I have to pull my matches out of the book so I don't forget to add them to my little pile over here. Okay, how many secret words did I get? 1, 2. 2 secret 2. Words.
Let's hear them sentences.
All right, so I said, yeah, I know, I remember how you were, like, super into that guy, Jeff, you know, the lead singer of the band, and you thought his songs were, like, a bop and fire and stuff, but you're not still really interested in him, are you?
Oh, wow.
Did that have both the words in it?
It did have both the words in it.
Is it bop and fire?
Words, Ben.
You can't ask those.
I don't need an answer, I just need to say it out loud.
I did right. Previously have Benjamin clarify to me that, like, words and conjugations did not count.
Okay, does anyone want to guess Jensi's secret?
Yeah, I guess.
All right, Jeanette, what do you guess Jensi's secret is?
Did you catch a building on fire?
No, I did not catch a building on fire.
All right.
Yeah, did you set Jeff on fire?
I did not set Jeff on fire. Good guess, though. But I can say that both of you did get the word fire correct.
This is the same guess that I had for Charlie's, is that you were Jeff.
and you've been trying to
get maybe to admit that she was in love with Jeff, because that would mean she was in love with you.
No. Good guess, though, but all right. No.
Okay. Jeanette.
All right. So, I guess it can be right after this. So, I kind of fulfilled my first goal of getting my dad to join, whatever. And so, my second goal, I guess maybe still has some sort of feelings for George Michael, except, like, she's kind of a little stubborn to admit it. So, her second goal is to have George Michael moved to Mumbai with her.
Oh.
Yeah, that's kind of what has to happen. So, yeah, so I guess maybe says, but you have to move to Mumbai with me. And I guess he says he has to think about it, but then, maybe 30 seconds later, he says yes without interruption.
Yeah, it's George Michael. He'll totally.
Yeah, yeah. He says he has to wait, but then he like just waits just to make the tension happen, and then he's like, "Oh yeah, no, I'm good." So I basically say, "Yeah, I don't know. I've got this new movie that I'm working on. It's called The Stones of Power, where." The Stones of Power are wanted, or that's not the name of the movie. So it's the Stones of Power that are wanted by good and evil wizards, and they want to put it in this giant magic glove.
Oh my goodness!
And then they're gonna have like this clap that is gonna harm half the population, And so we decided the best name is the Magic Clapping Wars. What do you think? Like, I think we're onto something here.
Yeah. Yeah, that's perfect. I love it. I'm going to support this.
Yeah, maybe we could get you in there. Would you want to be in acting? Have you ever thought about being in acting? Maybe you could be an extra or something.
Okay, I'd love it. And then, like, I can promote it on my band's page and stuff.
Yeah.
All right.
Yes.
All right.
Does anyone want to contest this scene?
Magic clapping words.
I don't like that apparently two of your words are wizard and clap. I don't care for that at all. But no, I won't actually contest the outcome.
Anyone else?
I'm all out of beans, so.
All right. So no one's contesting. Jeanette, do you any traits?
I think so. I mean, I kind of just strong-armed George Michael to move to the other side of the planet.
You've also got just a general air of boredom to you, which just
in
the voice.
Like, yeah, sure, I'll get married, whatever.
All right, did you say any secret words?
I know
you
did. I used three of
them.
How
many?
I used three.
Okay, let's hear those sentences.
It was the stones of power that are wanted by good and evil wizards to harm the population with a magic glove. using a giant glove that is going to use this clapping, and it's called the Magic Clapping Wars.
Can I just say that Jeanette has done more work on these secret sentences?
I haven't! Yeah, yeah, I literally did it 5 minutes before we recorded it!
Definitely the part that you, like, latched onto the most. You were like, yeah.
This I kind of like cheated. I just used movies that exist and made them shitty.
Yeah.
I mean, it's gold. It's beautiful. Does anyone want to guess Jeanette's secret?
Yes.
Go for it.
You do?
Yeah. Okay. Do it. So, my guess is that maybe is actually at war with space wizards. Who are trying to take over the world with their supremacy and their magic. And she is trying to push them back with the power of movies.
Any of that?
And they're fascists.
I don't think a single word was used. I'm sorry.
Oh my gosh.
All right.
Okay. I want to give it a go.
Okay.
All right.
Maybe accidentally let her script for the Clapping Wars get leaked, and it was picked up by Marvel, and so she's trying to make a rival indie movie that will supersede it in the box office.
No.
Dang.
I don't think you used any of those words.
Jeanette, do you have any one? Do you want a secret guess?
Oh.
You said you wanted to try mine, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. Hang on, let me give it a minute. You kind of started this cult with Now You See Me, and there's a message in the eye in the movie? No? Yes? Yes?
I mean, that's pretty close. I mean, I don't think anyone's going to get it, like, word for word what it actually is, so I'm willing to just go ahead and reveal
it. Well, let's save it in case Ben wants to try.
I just have those words, like, written down. I have no idea how they'd be related. Like, is there, a magic statue that has a message in the eyes? I don't know.
You have all of the key phrases. Now you see me, message, join, and the eye. Those are my key phrases.
All right, well, if you think she got close enough to get it, well, what's your secret?
Joe believes that the movie Now You See Me was an actual invitation / message for people to join the Eye, and he's been trying to, over the last 10 years, get noticed by the organization to be let in.
Oh, nice. Nice.
You think it's on the documentary? Yeah.
Hail Hydra.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so, Jeanette, just give yourself a fistful of tokens, and we'll move on to Ben's turn.
So I kind of have nothing else to do in this game, so I think I should take, like, not a real turn here and finish out with the Arrested Development. On the next Arrested Development, Tobias arrives in Bollywood, and he's, like, wearing, like, it looks like an off-brand Indiana Jones outfit, but it's, like, purple. And so a guy walks up to him that's dressed like Belloc from the first Indiana Jones movie. And he says, "Mr. Funke?" And Tobias says, "Yes." And he hands him a cease and desist letter. And Tobias says, "I've made a huge mistake." So that's the end of our Arrested Development Season 4 / 5 remake. Thank you for joining us. If you're curious what everyone's secret is, we recorded that, and I'm going to stick it right here at the end. So you can see if you guessed right or not.
Alex's Michael Bluth secret was Michael accidentally committed some light treason by building model homes in North Korea through an Australian building company.
George Oscar Bluth believed that the movie Now You See Me was an actual invitation to join the Eye.
So, don't you all know there's always money in the banana stand? I'm just glad that I got the rest of it out before you two burned it down. I've been saving it all in an offshore account for over 10 years under the name Nelly Featherbottom. Currently, there's over $750,000 invested.
George's secret is he was selling the timers from the cornballers to the North Korean military for their missiles. And that's why
Oscar? Were you Oscar?
I was, but I wasn't going to make it a secret, that part of the secret. But yeah.
Lucille's secret was that after offering all of the Bluth Company shares to Stan Sitwell, she's been moonlighting as a lounge singer performing jazz standards around Newport Beach under a stage name for money to make ends meet, but she secretly loves it.
After George Michael found out that the lead singer of the band that he was in was also with the love of his life, aka maybe, he decided to set the lead singer's classic guitar on fire.
All right, so maybe is very uncomfortable in the United States, like she's wearing the parka and the sunglasses, because before all this happened, she fed a giant panda a corn dog and made them extremely sick. So she is actually currently wanted in the United States for causing harm to an endangered animal.
Did you guess anyone's? Because I did not get any of these. If you did get them, tell us on social media. And while you're at it, go ahead and send us an idea for how you would have remade these somewhat disappointing seasons of Arrested Development. Or tell us how we're big, fat haters who should have left it alone because it was good and awesome. Bye.